Hello, my name is Karl Moore. I'm a third-year psychology major from Vallejo, California, and in this presentation, I will be going over a proposed study. Everyone has a favorite song they know the moment they hear the first note. You're transformed back to a particular moment in your past. That significant time can be either good or bad. The brain stores memories through a process called encoding, consolidating, and retrieving. People can often recall the first time hearing the first song and where they were when they heard it. It's reported that in 2016, on average, Americans listened to a record high of 27 hours of music per week. In the last 2 years, hip-hop music in America has gotten a tremendous amount of notoriety, and it's actually even become the most popular genre of music in the country. The repetition of rhymes in hip-hop music works well with the brain because repetition produces long-term memory by stimulating strong chemical interactions at the synapses of neurons in the hippocampus of a person's brain. A topic that will be investigated is hip-hop music's effect on the hippocampus and memory. The topic is important to psychology because there is limited research on it, and it is hypothesized that hip-hop music will have a positive effect on the hippocampus and memories of its listeners. Now, at this point of the presentation, I will be diving into the participants of this study. The participants of the study will be 30 undergraduate students who will be recruited from introductory psychology classes at a comprehensive regional university in the eastern United States. All of the students who volunteer will be able to participate, but only the data of students ranging in ages from 17-year-olds to 25-year-olds will be included in the analysis. It is required that at least 40% of the prospective participants are avid listeners of hip-hop, and this will be determined through questionnaires. The participants do not need to be professional or have any experience professionally in hip-hop music. People from different regions, races, and socioeconomic statuses will be used for this study. All students who participate will receive a $20 bill at the end for compensation of this experiment. On to the design of the study. The proposed experiment is a longitudinal study. It is an event-related design. The trials of the study are presented randomly and focus on the cognitive effect of rap music's effect on the activation in the hippocampus. The independent variable of this study will be each participant's music preference, whether they listen to rap music or not. The dependent variable of the study are the results and values acquired from an fMRI that will be given to each participant to assess brain activity in the hippocampus and its effect on short-term memory. The measure of memory will be verbal declarative memory. It will be examined using the Wechsler memory scale. It will examine immediate recall and delayed recall of the memory of a memory encoding task. It will also be examined by comparing the hippocampal activation and white and gray matter contrast on bold images of participants who listen to rap music and participants who do not listen to rap music. Now on to the materials that will be used for this study. The study will take place in a medical research center. A GE 1.5 Sigma Echo Speed 16-channel MRI ISO2 will be used to conduct the fMRI. The software for the machine will be E-Prime. For the fMRI brain imaging data, T2 weighted bold images will be used on a General Electric 1.5 Sigma HD TX 3.0 scanner with a 16-channel high-resolution brain coil. Cochin 2000 will also be a software used that will deliver the different types of stimuli. Presentation is also a software that will be used that will manage neural behavior. Two questionnaires will be used for this survey study. The survey studies will be the short test of musical preferences and the BFI, Big Five Inventory, which includes questions that ask students to identify what genre of music that they like the most. There will also be a memory encoding task that will consist of 20 monochrome images of full male portraits. 200 professions will be assigned randomly to the faces and typed below the faces. 50% of the professions belonging to the category artists and another 50 belonging to the category teachers. In addition, 20 control stimuli will be presented during the encoding, which will consist of a head template without any information. Participants will be asked to memorize the face professions, and the pictures will be projected on an LCD projector while they are in the fMRI. Following the materials is the procedure. The study will be held on 6 afternoons, Monday through Friday, during the middle of the semester. The participants will be given a consent form and both questionnaires. Once they are done, a research assistant will explain to the participants the memory encoding task. They will be given 2 minutes to memorize each face along with their prospective job description. The participants will be given 20 monogram images. After 2 minutes are up, the research assistant will gather up the images from the participants. The duration of the procedure will average 45 minutes to 1 hour. The participants will be required to lie motionless during the fMRI scanning. There will be a fan and a two-way intercom for communication and comfort between the participant and technologist. Once the fMRI has begun, the pictures will be displayed above them, and they will be asked if they remember seeing this face in the picture given to them earlier. If they state that they remember seeing the picture, they will be asked what was the labeled job description of the prospective picture. The task will be repeated 20 times. The assistant will then thank them for participating in the study and hand them their compensation and a debriefing sheet as they exit the building.